Assalamualaikum and hello everyone. In this video, I will explain about non-probability sampling technique. Non-probability sampling technique is a sampling method where the samples are gathered in a process that does not give all the individuals in the population equal chances of being selected. Jadi maksudnya dalam non-probability technique ini, all the elements in the population does not have equal chances of being selected. Okay. Going to use this technique when the generalizations concerning the population is not important. Besides, we are going to use this method when the sampling frame is not available or when the sampling frame is difficult to obtain. Jadi kalau sampling frame susah kita nak dapatkan, kita akan guna non-probability sampling technique. If the sampling frame is available, we are going to use probability sampling technique. Non-probability sampling technique is also being used when the researchers aim to do a pilot study. Pilot study is a study done before the actual fieldwork. And sometimes, when the researcher has limited budget or time, or workforce, the researcher will also use this kind of sampling technique. Okay. In this non-probability sampling technique, the sample may or may not represent the entire population. Thus, the results cannot be used in generalizations pertaining to the entire population. The first technique in non-probability sampling technique is the convenience sampling. Okay. The name itself, convenience here, means the researcher selects the respondent at his own convenience. Okay. Maksudnya researcher tu dia akan ambil, dia akan pilih respondent dia pada pada masa-masa yang dia senang untuk dapatkan respondent. And the respondents are selected because they happen to be in the right place at the right time where the researcher is conducting a survey. For example, now I want to do a research about customer satisfaction in a department store. Okay, so I want 100 samples. So to get that 100 samples, I will do convenience sampling where I will ask the first 100 customers that enter the department store to answer my questionnaire. Okay, next, we have the judgmental sampling. Judgmental sampling is the procedure of selecting respondents for research solely based on the judgment of the researcher. This sampling technique, the researcher will judge something first to select the respondent. Okay. The researcher selects a respondent whom he feels possesses certain characteristics that represent the population of interest. And normally, the judgment is based on the researcher's knowledge, professional judgment, or prior experience. Okay, for example, in a study where a researcher wants to do a survey on excellent students. Okay, let's say now my study is about how to excel in study. Okay, so the researcher will ask directly to the individuals who graduated with CGPA 4.0 because in his judgment, when someone graduated with CGPA 4.0, of course, this person is an excellent student. So instead of going to ask random people, random students yang kita tak tahu dia punya CGPA berapa, so better this researcher terus pergi kepada students who graduated with a CGPA 4.0. We have quota sampling. It is the procedure of selecting respondents who possess certain characteristics determined by the study. Okay, so in this sampling kita akan select respondent yang ada certain characteristic yang mana this characteristic mencapai objective of the study. In quota sampling, we will select respondent non-randomly, okay, according to some fixed or given quota to fill from specified subgroups of the population. This quota sampling is quite similar to convenience sampling, but differs in terms of the flexibility to choose the respondent he wants. Alright, for example, interview done between 10 a.m. to 4 p.m. So this is the quota. The quota is set by the researcher himself, yang mana respondent akan diambil dari pukul 10 hingga 4 p.m. So this is the quota. Alright. So instead of conducting an interview from 10 a.m. until night, so this researcher set the interview session from 10 a.m. to 4 p.m. Alright, example, let's say the study of students' hobby. Now we set the quota, that means we set only few hobbies of student. Contoh, saya hanya set 3 hobby. Hobby number 1, reading. Hobby number 2, cycling. And maybe hobby number 3, watching movies. Okay. So instead of ambil beberapa hobi yang banyak, kita hanya set kuota untuk ambil kira 3 jenis hobi sahaja. Right? Alright, next we have snowball sampling. It is the procedure of selecting the subsequent respondent based on the information provided by the earlier respondents. And the process continues until enough respondents are obtained. This snowball sampling is also known as chain referral. Okay? That means in this snowball sampling, the researcher only needs to identify the first respondent who has the characteristics required by the study. And then, to get the next respondent, the researcher will ask the first respondent to recommend another potential subject who also meets the criteria of the research. Okay. For example, you want to conduct a study of cancer survivors and you only know one person who is a cancer survivor. So now this is your first respondent. So you go to this respondent and then you collect data from this respondent and then you ask this respondent who else is the cancer survivor. So this person will recommend his friend who is a cancer survivor and then you go to the next person. So that is your second respondent. Okay, next. To get the third respondent, you are going to ask the second respondent who is the potential subject, who is the cancer survivor. So this person will recommend another person. So the next person will be your third sample. Okay, biasanya kita akan guna snowball sampling bila our research is about something yang susah kita nak dapatkan dia punya sampel. Okay, contoh lain. Survey on victims of skim cepat kaya. You guys tahu ke ramai orang yang kena skim cepat kaya? Tak tahu kan? Kita hanya tahu a few percent yang menjadi mangsa skim cepat kaya. So kalau study about victims of skim cepat kaya, kita akan guna snowball sampling. Okay, jadi kita akan tanya orang yang pertama tu siapa lagi yang pernah jadi mangsa skim cepat kaya. Jadi orang pertama tu akan recommend orang lain yang pernah jadi victims. Orang yang kedua ni pun akan recommend orang lain yang jadi victim. Okay. Okay, that's all for non-probability sampling. So in non-probability sampling, we have 4 techniques. The first one, convenience sampling. The second one, judgmental sampling. Number 3 is quota sampling. And number 4 is snowball sampling. Okay, for convenience sampling, the advantages of using this sampling technique, number 1, is easy and less expensive. Actually, convenience sampling is the least expensive technique. Okay. Advantage number two, convenient sampling requires less time compared to other sampling, and it is most convenient technique. Okay. But the weaknesses of convenient sampling are the selection of the sample might be biased, and number two, it is not recommended for descriptive research because the samples may not represent the whole population. Alright. As for judgmental sampling, this technique of sampling is less expensive, require less time, and the sample are guaranteed to meet specific objective if our judgment is correct. Alright. But in judgmental sampling, it does not allow generalization, and sometimes our judgment might not correct. So this will lead to inaccurate result because our judgment is something that is very subjective. Next, for quota sampling, the advantage is the sample can be controlled for certain characteristic because we set the quota for that characteristic. But the weaknesses of this quota sampling are, number one, the selection of the sample might be biased, and then there is no assurance of representativeness. Okay, the last one here, the snowball sampling. This sampling technique allows the researchers to reach populations that are difficult too. Okay, macam tadi saya bagi example, study on victims of skim cepat kaya. So, untuk dapatkan sampel memang sangat susah, jadi kita akan guna snowball sampling. Okay. Another advantage of snowball sampling is it is very simple and very cost efficient. Okay, but the weaknesses of snowball sampling are, number one, it is very time consuming, and then sometimes the researcher has no idea of the true distribution of the population. Okay, that's all for this video. I hope you learned something from this video. Okay, in my next video, we will discuss about data collection methods. Okay, thank you for watching.